really hot. We better get going. Wow, you look stunning. If we weren't getting married tomorrow, I'd propose to you myself.
No, don't let that stop you.
You know, my therapist strongly urged that I find substitutes for my drinking.
Get those thoughts out of your head. Mind you.
Whatever you say.
Find a way back.
Appreciate it. Its innate charm.
Never quite be the same.
Maybe we should consider stocking it with food and spending our entire honeymoon here going up and down. Let me rephrase that.
Honeymoon, you know, we never really talked about where we're gonna go, and my gosh, we're getting married.
Tomorrow. We'll just go to the airport with my credit card and then honeymoon wherever we like. Cairo, Bombay, Tahiti, you name it.
Well, that's
good. Unless you had something else in mind.
No. I was thinking, do you think it's possible that we're rushing things a little?
Well, looks like our guests of honor a little bit late.
Well, let's hope they show up soon. Most of us wouldn't be caught dead in the same room if it weren't for Julian Mason.
Dad, what do you think? You want me to call their office?
Maybe they elope. You know, wouldn't that be romantic?
Do you have any idea how long we've dragged this out? Do you have any idea what people would do to us if we put it off again?
No, I understand that. Really, I do. I was just thinking about walking down the aisle tomorrow, and I thought that we still had some things unresolved. And I thought, hell, what would be so terrible about waiting a week or two?
Oh, come on, Wainwright. Cut the role reversal. I'm the one who's supposed to be dragging my feet. You're not going to leave me at the altar again, are you?
No. I love you more than I ever have.
Well, then what's the problem? What's the holdup? Oh, wait, I know what it is. I'm not dragging my feet now, so you feel obligated to pick up the slack, right?
No, that's not it, really.
Well, then whatever it is, I'm warning you. You can't get out of it. I'm not going to allow you to default on this one, Julia. So you're bound by your legal word to walk down the aisle with me tomorrow and in front of witnesses, join together with me in the bonds of holy matrimony as long as we both shall live. I think it's going to be a red letter day, don't you? Shall we go?
I lied. Sophia went to Greg's school. I think you should let them air this, Cece. Much more entertaining than your blustery little toast.
There's something so comforting about coming home.
And that Kelly and Eden couldn't be here.
Yes. Sophia, have you heard any word at all from Eden and Kelly?
No, I haven't. We just hope the Cruz has found them.
And no word about when they'll be back?
No, I hope to hear in a day or two.
You know, Mason, Eden and Cruz are my best friends. I mean, she's your sister. I really don't think that we should have the wedding without them.
I'm sure they'll understand, Donna.
Well, I know, but... Even so, I think we should wait for them.
Another toast? I didn't think you could.
You can all tell how much my son loves my toasts. Look, I realize, everybody, that we're going to be toasting the bride and groom tomorrow after the ceremony, but may I say, in front of all my friends and relatives, how proud I am of my son and how happy we'll be to welcome Julian to the family officially. So, the toast to tomorrow's bride and groom.
Yes. Yes.
Mom.
Yes.
What if Emily and I slipped out for a little while? Do you think the cap was to be offended?
Where do you want to go?
I thought we might go down that little...
That's right. Mm-hmm.
Yes, darling. Too bad you're getting stuck with Augusta as a sister-in-law.
Oh, we've managed to maintain a degree of civility for the past few months.
You look great, you know that? And I am very proud of you.
What's wrong?
Nothing.
Julia, now come on. You've come up with three reasons already tonight why you should postpone the wedding.
Well, I do think the Cruzanita should be there. I don't understand. I thought the idea of the three of you finally coming together was what pulled you through the whole year.
It is.
Well, then what's the problem? You got your dream?
Grab it.
I don't know where all these feelings are coming from.
I would expect this from Mason, but he's nothing less than ecstatic about this wedding.
I don't... Yeah, maybe. I don't know. He's just not like him.
Well, he's sober. Is he supposed to be the same person that he was when he was drinking?
Maybe he's just acting this way because he thinks that's the way somebody sober is supposed to act.
So what? That's what you wanted all along. You know what it is? You know what it is? I don't want to spend the rest of my life being his caretaker, and I'm afraid that's what it's going to end up being.
Because then you think about all the times you took care of Dad.
That's right, and I don't want to repeat it. I can't repeat it.
I'm sure that the last wedding you attempted is weighing on you. You had all your hopes up, and they were shattered. That would spook anyone.
I suppose.
Julia, you know how I feel about Mason. Well, lately, we've been able to tolerate each other. And as painful as it is for me to say, I think he's actually turned over a new leaf.
I know he has. But maybe he's not the only one.
This is your chance to grab a dream. You'd be a fool not to.
There you are.
I'm sorry.
There's no problem. It's just getting kind of late. I thought we should get home. Tomorrow's a big day. You know, I've been thinking about it.
About what?
Well, the life we've been having together, living in sin, has been pretty good. And if you wanted to continue that way for a while, I wouldn't mind.
Are you trying to back out of this now?
I thought you wanted to back out.
Now, why did you get a crazy idea like that?
Maybe from the fact that you brought up six different reasons why we should put it off. Like we have to resolve things, we have to wait for Cruz and Eden to come home, we have to wait for the cows to come home.
I didn't say anything about the cows. You think that I'm going to let you out of my sight? You're dead wrong. I'm going to keep you here until you're legally man and wife.
That could be a long night.
Don't count, Mama. Comfort him, honor him, and keep him in sickness and in health. And forsaking all others, keep only unto him for as long as we both shall live.
And Mason, will you take this woman as your wife?
I will. I will love her, comfort her,
and massage your feet.
What?
He said, will you massage my feet? Well, you know, when I come home from a hard day.
Isn't that sort of covered in the sickness and health clause?
Mason, we discussed the vows beforehand. Could you just say them?
I will love her, comfort her, massage her feet.
Come home early, shop for groceries.
Come home early, shop for groceries.
Buy a dog.
Buy a dog? I'm allergic!
What's wrong?
Nothing.
You wake up screaming the night before I'm getting married.
All right, it's not a problem. I'm not offended. It's okay. Go to sleep. It'll be over before you know it. Kind of like a tetanus shot. Well, it won't hurt afterwards.
That's a relief. So hard to walk the dog when you've got a sore arm.
What dog?
You don't know how glad I am to hear you say that.
Mason.
Go to sleep.
the truth, was that really a bad dream?
No, I just shouldn't have had coffee. So close to going to sleep.
Right, it's the caffeine. Every muscle in your body is, Richard.
That's no muscle. I'm just glad to see you.
I know, sweetie. It's okay. We're all scared. Everybody's scared of getting married.
Yeah, I guess it's just conditioning after growing up with a man who botched every attempt at matrimony he ever tried. Guess maybe I'm afraid I'm doomed to repeat the pattern.
You're not your father, you know. I would never marry a man as controlling as he is.
How do you know I won't turn into a domineering tyrant the moment I say I do?
I don't.
I won't. Or if I do, at least I'll be sneaky about it. My father's problem was whenever he tried to manipulate somebody, he was always so damned obvious. Hello? Oh, my God.